So my topic is choose to forgive. Did you hear? Choose to forgive. You know, we are human beings, and in our day-to-day life, there are so many things we face that we get angry, we get, you know, anxious, we get irritated, we face so many struggles, and sometimes because of others we suffer. We suffer loss, sometimes because of others we suffer. We suffer loss, we suffer humility, we are insulted because of somebody's mismanagement, because somebody was not responsible enough, right? And you are insulted for that, you are misbehaved or mistreated for that, and you have that, you know, grudge in your heart, you have complaints in your heart, and sometimes it's easy to forgive, you know, when somebody is close to you, you forgive easily, you say, okay, it's fine, it happens, it's life, right? But sometimes it takes longer than you expect, right? It takes time, sometimes it takes years to forgive your friend, your people, your relatives, maybe your neighbor, I don't know, because early in the morning I was just, you know, in the mode of prayer, I got this powerful topic, I was telling Lord, what is your will? But I believe if God has given this topic, definitely it's going to talk to our hearts. So I would encourage you that God has given us this beautiful verse that we need to be kind and compassionate and forgive each other. Why we need to forgive each other? Because in Christ, God has forgiven you. God has forgiven you and me. Have you received the forgiveness of God? We all have received the forgiveness of God. We are forgiven no matter what kind of sins we have committed in our young age, or we have been committing, or every day the mistakes we are committing in front of people, or maybe people are not watching us, but God is watching us, and in front of Him, before Him, some things are called sins, but still He is giving us grace to come out of that. He is helping us. He is showing His mercy upon us. He is forgiving us every day. He has forgiven us because on the cross, Jesus shed His blood. He died on the cross. You know why? Because He wanted His people to be free. He wanted to provide forgiveness. Forgiveness is the most essential thing in your life. You may not have wealth. You may not have, you know, good contacts. As I always say I have said in my previous sermons also, that sometimes we think that good contacts are really important, high position is really important. But today I want to tell you that forgiveness is really important in your life. Because if you are not forgiven by your people, by God, it's really tough to move forward. And if you are not moving forward, then what will you do with a stagnant life, right? So there are few points which I want to share with you. You can note it down, and definitely it will help you to see that how you can forgive others and why forgiveness is important. Before I move to my points, I would like to tell you a small definition regarding forgiveness. Forgiveness is a conscious, deliberate decision to release feelings of resentment or vengeance toward a person or group who has harmed you, regardless of whether they, you know, deserve forgiveness. Did you hear? Is it powerful? Sometimes people don't deserve your forgiveness, but you have to. I will tell you why. That's why the name is forgive. You have to let it go. Give. Give it freely as God has given. That's why I have taken the verse from Ephesians chapter 4, because Paul is saying it so beautifully, because God has forgiven you in Christ, and we have to forgive like God who has forgiven all our sins. If we try to remember our sins we have committed in our mind, in our hearts, through our actions, through our hands, we cannot even imagine. We don't want to even remember those sins. We don't want to remember. But God has forgiven everything. God has forgiven forgotten, given you grace, given you blessings, given you everything you demanded, you prayed for. He answered your prayers also. After you committed sins, you repented, you received His forgiveness. Because God wanted His people to have a life of abundance. That's why forgiveness is important, right? So let's see the first point which I want to share with you is forgiveness is a truly Christian virtue. Why we need to forgive? If you are a true Christian, you need to forgive. We must forgive. Because people will know you are kind, you have made mistake, somebody just collided with your car, they just made a loss. Still you say, okay, you go on your way, I'll do what I can. That means you are showing your Christian life that yes, I am Christian. I can forgive easily. It's tough, I know. It's really tough. God has taught me how to forgive. That's why I'm able to preach today. I have learned this thing from Jesus through prayers. When I sat in His presence, He helped me to forgive completely. It's really tough. I'm telling you, it's tough to forgive, but God's grace can help you to overcome and to forgive just like God has forgiven you. Right? We remember that the verse chapter, you know, in the book of Matthew chapter 6 verse 14-15, what it says, if you forgive the sins of others, your sins will be forgiven, right? And if your sins are forgiven, definitely God is going to bless you. Your prayers will be answered. You need to show your Christian character that yes, you are really a man of God, woman of God, believer through your forgiving nature. Right? We know the story that when a person comes to the altar, he wants to offer the prayer. Right? And what God says, leave your gift here. If something you have against your brother or sister, just go and reconcile with him or her first. Reconcile with them. That means God wants to say, if you are not forgiving somebody, how can I forgive you? And without forgiveness, no prayer can be answered. And the second point is, forgiveness brings the answers of your prayers. That's why you need to forgive. Verse is so clear. I don't even have to explain to you. You all are smart people, educated one. You know it so well. Forgive from your heart. I have written one beautiful line. You cannot, you know, bring unforgiving heart to a holy altar. Unforgiving heart, you are keeping so many things in your heart. Grudges, complaints. You have this thing, okay, this man has done this thing to me. This woman has spoken like this. Ruined my image, ruined life, so many things you have in your heart, and still you are praying and praying in other tongues. You think that God is hearing you? No. We must be clear with God first that yes, Lord, I know things have happened. I know I was also wrong. Lord, you give me strength to forgive now. I choose to forgive. Don't forget my topic. Choose to forgive. I choose to forgive, Lord. Amen. Are you listening to me? I hope you all are with me. We need to tell God that, yes, Lord, I am ready to forgive. Because if you are ready to forgive, only your prayers will be answered and you will be used mightily by God. Because God knows there are so many tribulations, so many things, so many problems you are going to face, and people will be responsible. Sometimes you are not. But yes, then you have to have a big heart to forgive people, hug people, love them, treat them well. You know, sometimes we say, okay, I forgive, but I will not talk. I will not respond properly. This is not a way of forgiveness. We have learned from our pastor, if you forgive, don't curse it, don't nurse it, don't rehearse it, right? So we need to forgive. Forgiveness is really important. You will enjoy your life like anything. My third point is, why to choose forgiveness? Why to forgive? Because you deserve peace. You deserve? Say, I deserve peace. Tell yourself, I deserve peace. Amen? You all deserve peace. I already told you the definition. Maybe that person doesn't deserve forgiveness, but you are forgiving. You know why? Because you want your life to be at peace. You want your relationship with people and God to be at peace. You don't want any grudges. You don't want anything to keep in your heart. And you don't want any obstacle. You know, if you don't forgive, there will be hurdles. There will be stone between you and God. And forgiveness can remove it. Just imagine. If you forgive, that stone will be removed automatically. That obstacle, that hurdle will be removed automatically because you are, you know, doing a favor for yourself. Do a favor for yourself first. And I want to tell you, forgive yourself. Sometimes we think that we are wrong, we blame ourselves, sometimes we commit mistakes and we always remember why I did this, why I did wrong. I also have done this. I'm telling you that it was really tough for me, but God has taught me, right? I also used to, you know, torture myself. Why you did that? Why you committed that mistake? Why you spoke wrong? But I learned that I should forgive myself. Because if I will forgive myself, I will make my life and my future bright. And I will allow God to work in my life. I will allow God to pour out His anointing upon my life. I will be able to pray according to His will. If I don't forgive myself or the people around me or the people who have hurt me, given me pain, or they are causing me any kind of suffering, right? So we need to forgive people. It's really tough. When people ruin your image, it's really tough to forgive. But I want to remind you, the great man Job, his friends were not with him. But Job had a forgiving heart. He forgave his friends and he prayed for his friends, right? And God blessed him. That's why God blessed him. Because he could see that Job is not keeping anything in his heart for his friends. Though his friends were giving so many things, they were against him. Many things have happened. But we know that Lord is searching the heart of people. And when we are keeping the heart of forgiveness, God blesses our lives. He is there to tell and guide us, and He is there to fight our battles. Because if you fight, you will say 100 things, nothing is going to happen. But if you forgive and focus on your work, God is going to bless you. He is going to change the mindset of people, change your life, change your destiny, change your future. Because in ministry, in any profession, in life, God wants people who have heart of forgiveness, who have big heart. Who can forgive, who can forget the mistakes of people, who can hug them, love them, treat them well. If you think that you want to go higher, if you want to serve the Lord, you must have such a big heart. You need to keep a big heart. Maybe people have looted you. Maybe people have taken money and didn't return when you need it. Still, pray to the Lord. Lord, you give me strength to forgive. Help me to forgive people who are making mistakes over and over. God knew this thing, that we are going to face challenges. We are going to face some crooked people in our life. That's why He gave us answers through Peter. Do you know? Peter asked Him, how many times shall I forgive my brother if he is sinning against me? making mistakes over and over? 7 times? Peter might be thinking, I was imagining that, okay, if 8th time he makes any kind of mistakes, I'm going to, you know, maybe slap his, or maybe something. He's going to argue or fight, or maybe he will slap his friend or if 8th time something happens. But see the smartness of Jesus. He says, not 7 times, but 77 times. And if you multiply it, it becomes, I believe, 490 times. 490 times, right? So that means there are so many things, so many mistakes are going to happen through you and through people. But choose to forgive. People, in my school time, I learned one thing. To err is human, to forgive is divine. During my school days, I used to learn these, idioms, phrases, good lines. I never thought it's going to help me. It's so practical. When we are reading the Bible, we see that everything God has talked about. God is so concerned about our spiritual health, our emotional health, our physical health. Because when we don't forgive, it deteriorates our mental health, our emotional health, because you will not be able to focus on your life. You will not be able to focus on God's given vision. Maybe you want to achieve any goal, you are not able to accomplish, because over and over things are coming in your mind. God wants to protect your memory. That's why he says, okay, something has happened, just forgive now. Let it go. Tell your friend, let it go. Let the hurt go. Enjoy. Enjoy yourself. Enjoy your life. You have only one life. We don't know what's going to happen in our future. Why to live in grudges? And one thing I want to tell again from my school calendar. They used to write one thought: life is too short to love, how people get time to hate. I understand these things now. My school has taught me beautiful things. I can share number of things from my school life, because it was just his grace that I was so conscious to learn those things from my teacher, from every quote, from every notice board, whatever they are posting, I used to learn, I used to read that, and God is helping me. I want to encourage all the teenagers, all the youths, people who are listening to me here and offline, online, I want to tell you, choose forgiveness. It's tough to choose, but decision is yours. You can make a right decision, you can choose forgiveness, and you can help yourself to move in a right way. Sometimes you don't need help, you need to help yourself. Do yourself a favor, as I have already said. Next thing we can see is Jesus. How does Jesus deal with forgiveness? How do you deal with enemies? He says, pray for your enemies. If somebody has hurt you, if somebody has done wrong with you, you can pray for that person. You can bless that person. Because Bible again says many times, bless your enemies, not curse them. You don't need to curse them. Bless their lives. Pray for them. Tell God, the Lord, you bless that man. Change the heart of that man. Change that person. He or she is so rude, so arrogant. His words are hurting me over and over. His attitude is hurting me. Some people's, words, they pierce the heart of people, right? And you don't like to talk to them. I know it's true. I'm also a human being. I have gone through so much. But I believe if we are in the presence of the Lord and we are asking His guidance, His grace, He will definitely give us grace, and we will help. We will pray for them. we will, you know, go to God and tell that, Lord, you bless that man, that woman, and change him, change her, so that he and, you know, I and that person can work together. In offices, we see people make mistake, they do something wrong with you. Sometimes they spoil your time, they spoil your image. So many things happen in our professional life, but there also maintain your spiritual life, maintain your godliness, so that you can see the hand of God. Your forgiveness will definitely melt the heart of your enemies. Definitely they will change. Are you with me? We remember the story of prodigal son. What happened here? We see the forgiveness of God. We see the forgiveness of Father. Our Heavenly Father forgives us. No matter how many mistakes we have made, the deepest sins we have committed, God is there to forgive us. We can also forgive our people, just like God. I know it's tough. I'm telling it again and again. It's hard sometimes. But Mark Twain once said like this, forgiveness is the fragrance that violet gives to the heel that has crushed it. Did you hear? It's a fragrance. You spread the fragrance. Love your people. Be kind to them. You all are young. Some of the people are in adulthood. I want to tell you one thing. Love is not a feeling. You have feeling today, and you can forgive 100 of mistakes of that person. But tomorrow, if that feeling vanishes, then you don't want to see that person. That's not called love. If you read from Paul, if you learn from Paul what he says, love does not keep the record of sins. Right? If you see in another translation, he says, does not keep the score of sins. How many sins you have committed? Love is a decision. It's not a feeling. Forgiveness is a decision. You cannot say, I don't feel to forgive that person. I don't feel to love that person. Feeling are temporary, but love is there, and love is a decision. You have to love your people. Take a decision that I will love no matter what. I will forgive no matter what. Don't, as lie has no stand to live. Same here. Understand this. Choose to forgive. And I want to end it here. That forgiveness is not an optional part of Christian life. God has forgiven us freely, completely, graciously, totally. So choose to forgive, just like God. God bless you.